Capital District Off Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 20 races to bring you, nearly half of them from Gulfstream Park, 9 that is. We're going to kick it off down on the turf. Here comes the bride.
There in the gate. Racing, and the Here Comes the Bride Stakes. Coasted hopped a bit at the start, his last early. From the center, Happy Mesa gets the first call. On the far outside, Conquest Hard Candy is moving through. India Mantuana comes away in the top flight, and so does Sweeping Patty in the run to the first turn. From the outside, Conquest Hard Candy and Edgard Zayas working over to lead from the outside, and now they lead it by a length and a half. Racing second, Sweeping Patty, India Mantuana rein back to run third today. It's a 2.5 length margin to the team of Happy Mesa with Coasted on her outside. The two at the back are Party Boat and Dream Dancing. Into the backstretch they go through the opening quarter in 23 and 2. And at 30-1, Conquest Hard Candy leads it by a length. On the outside, Sweeping Patty is second. India Mantuana now races from third. Racing on and fourth is Coasted in range about 3 lengths behind. Dream Dancing tries to improve. So does Party Boat. And down at the inside, Happy Mesa. Separated by 6 lengths in the run to the half-mile pole. The opening half-mile went in 47 and 3, and they swing around the far turn in the 30th running of the Here Comes the Bride, and Conquest Hard Candy leads it 3/4 of a length, Sweeping Patty second. India Mantuana ready to roll, but so is Coasted on the outside. Coasted is third, 3 wide and on the attack. Dream Dancing needs a little racing room. Party Boat keeps her in, and at the inside, Happy Mesa, any one of the 7 in with a chance with 1/4 mile to go. 3/4, 1/11 and 2, they turn in. Conquest Hard Candy has the lead. Out in the center, Coasted set down for the drive. Leperu begging for room for Dream Dancing. No place to go yet. In deep stretch, Coasted has the lead. Here's Dream Dancing with the seam now. Can Dream Dancing catch Coasted? Dream Dancing, Coasted, it's Dream Dancing. Dream Dancing got through and got up to nail Coasted on the money in 140 and 3.
Dream Dancing wins the photo finish. Julian Leperu aboard. He had a big afternoon on Saturday. We'll get to him more later in the program. Mark Cassie trains John Oxley, owns in the Familiar Silks. Second choice in the wagering, the offspring of Tappet, returns $5.60. The 6-5 favorite, Coasted, making the first start of the year off the Breeders' Cup. Runner-up finishes second. Party Boat finishes third. Over to the dirt, the one-turn dirt mile of Fred Hooper.
There, Rimigate. They're off in the Fred Hooper. Level beginning. From the center, Tale of Saval and Birdsong begin nicely. Realm is not far away. On the far outside, that's Greenpoint Crusader. And Bravo's getting after Mr. Jordan to show speed as they exit the one-mile chute. Birdsong has a narrow lead. Mr. Jordan is up to challenge from second. Rein back third is Tale of Saval. Down at the inside, his stablemate Realm follows along fourth. Greenpoint Crusader is on the outside fifth. Then back at the inside goes War Story second last, and the trailer is High Riverside. They cover the opening quarter in 23 seconds flat. And up front, Mr. Jordan leads by a head. Birdsong on the outside second. Realm is now third. Tale of Saval is in range fourth. 2 back to Green Point Crusader. He's racing in fifth with War Story on his inside. The favorite's about 4 lengths behind. Stretch of another 3 lengths back to High Riverside. And it's 7 to the trailer, Fromento. The opening half mile went in 46 seconds flat. It's Birdsong and Julian Leparu, less than 3 furlongs from home, and in front by a length, Mr. Jordan second. Then the Barkley tag pair of Realm and Tale of Saval. They're into second and third respectively now, working 4 better than War Story. Greenpoint Crusader has plummeted to last. He's not picking up his feet. Moving by him is Fromento, then High Riverside as they turn for home. Birdsong off the top of the turn with the lead. Tale of Saval set after him second. Realm between horses is now third with an 1/8 of a mile to go in the Hooper. Leperu straightens up Birdsong and he has the lead. Paco trying to get up with Realm from second. Then Tale of Saval on the outside third. But through it all, Birdsong is in front. Realm second. Tale of Saval third. Fromento from far back to get fourth. War Story ran fifth in 136 flat.
Named after one of the great men of the game, this is the two-word Birdsong. Ian Wilkes, Mary Lou Whitney, Julian Leperu wins again. One quick note here is the dirt course at Gulfstream Park on Saturday yielded some rather slow times at the end of the day, except
In the Fred Hoover, Birdsong is 136.07. Well, I folks, on that racetrack, that seems to be pretty good. The winner trade in 26th round finishes the second. Green Point Crusader gets a second start. We're tied by the 2-1 favorite. Beats one horse, finishing seventh. Up next for your Phillies on the turf of the Sand Springs.
And they're off in the Sand Springs. From the center, Catch a Glimpse breaks right on the money, but so does the favorite Celestine. And these two get acquainted early as they run past the finish line the first time. Leparu will rein Catch a Glimpse back to race in second behind the speed of Celestine. So Ortiz, offensive-minded, and Celestine leads the way. Floats all a little bit wide into that first turn, so Catch a Glimpse had to go three wide. Ice Festival is now racing in third from Rontos Lily in fourth. Down at the inside, it's Tila from fifth and Always Thinking. And the trailer is the gray Lori's Store. Separated by six lengths in the run to the backstretch, and Celestine leads by a length. On the outside, Catch a Glimpse is a bit closer second. 2.5 clear of Ice Festival, who runs third. Then Rontos Lily in fourth. Tila down at the inside is fifth. Always Thinking is second last, and trailing the field is Lori Star through the opening quarter in 23-4. They race to the half-mile pole, and the two principals in the wagering are 1-2. With the lead, Celestine three parts of a length. On the outside, it's Catch a Glimpse in second. 2.5 clear of Tila, then Ice Festival in the two-path. Lori Storr has moved up two spots ahead of Rontos Lily, and from between them, Ori's Thinking as they round the far turn. Celestine and Jose Ortiz have the lead past the quarter pole. They're drifting wide off the second corner as well. That'll give Catch a Glimpse a shot on the outside. These two, 2.5 better than Lori Storr, and they're into the stretch now, and up top, Celestine still has the lead. Catch a Glimpse trying everything she can to get after the leader second, then Lori Storr and Always Thinking, but inside the final furlong, Celestine will be sharp in victory. She'll take them all the way and win it by 2.5. Catch a Glimpse second. Lori Storr third. Always Thinking fourth. Then Ice Festival in 134-2.
Well, right from the get-go, the attack was out of the box. Christoph Mott, Trent Celestine, Jose Ortiz, the 3-5 favorite, to the front. Catch a Glimpse making the first start.
Since the Breeders' Cup finishes second. Celestine making the first start since the Breeders' Cup. Also different races, but Catch a Glimpse was the 8-5 second choice, really just a merry-go-round race for the exacta. Lori Storr finishes third in the Sand Springs. Up next, Phillies and Mares, a distance of ground on the turf named after the very, very good mare of the late 1970s, 1980, the very one.
Imigate. Racing in the very one stakes. Good start in the center for Earring, who begins nicely. Page is on the outside. Widest of all, here's Quiet Kitten. Down at the inside, Orlorda is moving up. Orlorda puts ahead in front as they run the finish line the first time. Quiet Kitten is second. Earring is taken back. Down at the inside goes Desiree Clary. Then Page. She was well away, but she's second last early. And the trailer is the favorite, Suffused. They run into the first turn, and Julian Leparu with the hot hand today. He has Orlorda on the lead by a length and a quarter. From the outside, Quiet Kitten is second. Desiree Clary rides the rail third. Earring in a bit tight while fourth. Page is fifth while three wide. And Suffused is unhurried at the back under Jose Ortiz. Only four lengths to make up through the opening quarter and a fairly snappy 22-4. They race into the backstretch, and Olorda has the lead, and she leads it by a length and a quarter. Quiet Kitten's a bit closer second. Page a three wide third. Desiree Clary at the inside fourth. Earring is between horses, and nothing yet, but not asked for much yet, is the trailer, Suffused. Past the half-mile pole after a 47-1 half-mile. Olorda has the lead. Quiet Kitten under Tyler Gaffleone launching an attack while second. Desiree Clary is all on the inside and now needs room third. Page has been three wide on both turns. In between horses is Earring, and Jose Ortiz making up his mind which way he wants to go with Suffused. He picks outside and he's on the attack. She's into fifth now, only a length and a half behind, as Olorda is the first to give way. Quiet Kitten takes the lead. Page moves to her, but a sharp move from Suffused on the outside. And Suffused has gone from last to first in 3/16 of a mile. And Suffused takes charge and moves away. Back to second is Quiet Kitten, then Earring to the outside and Page. Left behind fifth is Desiree Clary. They're all left behind by a sharp run from Suffused. Look at her go. Suffused and Jose Ortiz wraps her up, and she still won it by six. Quiet Kitten was second. Page third. Earring fourth in 151-2.
And setting a new course record, eclipsing last year's course record set in the very one by the runner who finished in last in this year's. Well, that's enough. But Suffused was brilliant. I needed her to be about that brilliant in the whale last summer. But she was outstanding from last to first as you heard, almost a blink of an eye. She wins by 5 as the 4-5 favorite. Judd Mott, Bill Mott, Jose Ortiz, $3.80. Quiet Kitten, the longest shot on the board at 23-1, finishes second. Paige at 21-1 finishes third. 3-year-old boys turn on the turf in the Palm Beach.
And they're off in the Palm Beach. Good start at the inside for Cowboy Culture with Sailing Home right alongside. In the center, here's Kitten's Cat moving up from the far outside. That's Adonis Creed trying to get over. Pagliacci is in tight between horses. Then back at the inside goes Giant Payday alongside Channel Maker, who works two better than Ticonderoga. He's dropped over from the nine post to the rail under Joel Rosario, and he's two better than Snap Decision, who trails in the run to the first turn. Up front, the leader now is Sailing Home and Leparu by a length. Kitten's Cat is second. Backing off third is Cowboy Culture. Adonis Creed is three wide. In between horses goes Channel Maker. Then comes Giant Payday and Baliachi. Second last and on hold is Ticonderoga. And Snap Decision trails. He's about 7 lengths off the lead of Sailing Home. Into the backstretch through a 23-1 opening quarter. And Sailing Home has the lead. On the outside, Kitten's Cat keeps him honest under Luis Saez, racing in second. Adonis Creed Park three wide third. At the inside, Cowboy Culture, well situated for Laurent Giroux, down toward the inside fourth, a length better than Channel Maker in fifth. Then comes Pagliacci and Giant Payday, second last and still not asked for much is Ticonderoga, and Snap Decision trails as they round the far turn. Up front now, here's Kitten's Cat to take a shot at Sailing Home. They work a length better than Adonis Creed third. Cowboy Culture will need to get a move on. Speaking of getting a move on, here's Ticonderoga giving the green light and switching three wide for the stretch drive. Ticonderoga tries to get to the leader, Kitten's Cat. Eighth of a mile to go. Kitten's Cat has the lead. Look at the momentum of Ticonderoga as he's up to challenge and power past. Ticonderoga and Joel Rosario going away. Kitten's Cat second. Snap Decision third. Then Sailing Home and Giant Payday in 140-1.
And setting a new stakes record, Ticonderoga making it back-to-back years for Chad Brown. Converge won last year at $7.80 as the chalk. Ticonderoga pays $7 even as the chalk for Joel Rosario. The offspring of Tappet wins by a length. Kitten's Cat finishes second. Snap Decision finishes third. Back to the dirt, the biggest field in the history of the Devona Dale.
And they're off in the Devona Dale. From the center, Saratoga Citizen gets the first call, but here's Miss Sky Warrior keyed up and up to challenge for the lead. Ellie's Honor also comes away in the top flight, so it will be Ellie's Honor to lead out of the chute three parts of a length. Modacious moves to be second. Miss Sky Warrior on the outside third. Yes, I'll go. Behind the speed wall fourth. Then it's the great Jordan Henny. She improves with an inside lane. Then it's a length back to Eloquent Riddle mid-flight and five lengths behind. Then it's the team of Summer Luck and Pretty City Dancer. In between horses goes Grand Cherry, a length better than Champagne Problems, followed by Bronze Cat and From Rhea to Riches, and it's about 7 or 8 to the trailer Aspen Hilltop. They make their way past the opening quarter in 23-3, and up front Jordan's Henny has now bulled through at the half mile to take the lead from Modacious second. Ellie's Honor's third. Miss Sky Warrior getting going four wide on the outside for Paco Lopez. Down at the inside, Yes I'll Go, followed by Eloquent Riddle, then Summer Luck and Pretty City Dancer. Stretch of another four to Bronze Cat and Grand Cherry, then From Rhea to Riches. Dropping anchor second last is Champagne Problems, and trailing the field is Aspen Hilltop as they run to the top of the stretch. 46-3 for the opening half mile. Modacious in between horses is up for a short lead. Miss Sky Warrior moves right with her off the turn, and Jordan's Henny's not finished yet. She's boxing on third. From behind the speed in Summerlock fourth, but Miss Sky Warrior confidently handled, rouse to the lead. Jordan's Henny dead game, fighting on second. Down the outside in Summerlock is into third. Miss Sky Warrior trying to get home. Summer Luck and Jordan Tenney second and third. Miss Sky Warrior. Miss Sky Warrior wins the Devona Dale from Jordan Tenney, then Summer Luck and Modacious in 138-2.
Miss Sky Warrior, the 2-1 favorite in this field of 14, where we had two horses not finished the race. Aspen Hilltop making the first start since Saratoga and Saratoga Citizen. But Miss Sky Warrior wins by a half a length, returning $6.40 for Kelly Breen and Paco Lopez. Jordan's Henny finishes second. Summer Luck finishes third. Up next, the Canadian Turf.
They're in the gate. They're off in the Canadian Turf Stakes. Heart to Heart was away very well and establishes the lead from the outside. Vision Perfect is trying to get over. Bondurant away in the top flight, and so is Conquest Panthera in the run to the first turn. Giant Run is reined back by Joe Bravo, racing in the three path. Down at the rail, that's McHagan. Then to the outside goes Dragon Bay. At the back of the pack, both Projected and Interpol. Around the first turn, and Heart to Heart has the lead by a length. From the outside, that's Vision Perfect in second. Conquest Panthera races from third. On hold fourth is Dragon Bay, while a bit wide. Giant Run between horses. Bondurant is at the rail. Then it's a length back to the team of on the inside, Projected, and then to his outside goes Dragon Bay, and the trailer is McHagan. Down the backstretch they continue through the opening quarter in 22-4. There's less than half a mile to go in the Canadian Turf, and with the lead, it's Heart to Heart, a half a length in front. Vision Perfect is second. Conquest Panthera is racing from third. Giant Run is fourth. Then to the outside, Dragon Bay fifth. Bondurant is sixth. Interpol tries to pick it up. Then to the inside goes Projected. McHagan gets started three wide at the back of the field as they round the far turn. Heart to Heart, tough to get by. He is through the opening half mile in 46-1, and he has the lead. In fact, he's widened a bit. Conquest Panthera and Giant Run trying to take up the slack. From behind the speed, it's Projected, then McHagan and Bondurant as they turn in. Three quarters, 109-2. And on top, Heart to Heart and Julian Leparu trying to get another furlong. They're strong up front. They lead now by three. Bondurant is through on the inside to try to get second from Conquest Panthera. But the Canadian Turf goes to Heart to Heart, wire to wire. Bondurant second, Conquest Panthera third in 132-3.
Julian Leparu wins his fourth of the day on the 6-5 favorite, goes to the front. Heart to Heart wins back-to-back Canadian Turfs. He joins the VID 95-96 and Equalize 88-89 as the back-to-back winners of the Canadian Turf in recent history. The 6-5 favorite returns $4.40. Bondurant finishes second. Conquest Panthera finishes third. And now for the three-turn turf marathon, named after the champ in the late 1970s, the McDermott.
And runners away in the McDermott. Good start toward the inside for Reporting Star, who's heading off to take the early lead. Flatlined will take a trail from second. Up on the outside, that's Smooth Daddy with Charming Kitten between horses. Then back fifth goes Bigger Picture. Down at the inside, it's Wake Forest, working a length clear of Watershed. Danish Dynaformer's in no hurry at this stage, racing down toward the inside. Twilight Eclipse is three wide. Mr. Maybe is second last, and the early trailer is Patterson Cross. They wheel into the stretch for the first occasion. And up front, Reporting Star and the hot right hand of Julian Leparu with a two-length lead. Racing in second now is Smooth Daddy. Down at the inside third is Charming Kitten. Up on the outside, Bigger Picture is now fourth, followed by Flatline in fifth. Stretch of two to Wake Forest. Well situated for Castellano. Mid-flight and 6.5 lengths off the lead. Patterson Cross has moved up a couple spots while still three wide. At the rail goes Watershed with Twilight Eclipse between them. The two at the back are Danish Dynaformer Former and Mr. Maybe. The opening quarter was 24 seconds flat. The half mile was quick, 47-4. Moving right along up top is Reporting Star. He leads it by a length and a half. Smooth Daddy second, taken off the inside. Charming Kitten is now third for Theron Giroux. Then down at the inside goes Flatline, followed by Bigger Picture. Still mid-flight is Wake Forest. Not asked for much yet, waiting for a cue. Then to the outside is Patterson Cross. Watershed is at the inside. Third last, Twilight Eclipse. Second last, Mr. Maybe. And Danish Dynaformer trails the lot of 11. With half a mile to go. They went through three quarters in 113-3, and they move now to the far turn run. They've yet to head Reporting Star. He has the lead, three parts of a length. Smooth Daddy is second. On the outside, Charming Kitten is now racing from third, flatlined, waiting for his turn fourth. Bigger Picture between horses. Castellano starts to get Wake Forest in gear. He'll have to go five wide, but he's on the attack. Meanwhile, Watershed rates for racing room. So does Twilight Eclipse. Mr. Maybe is last. They line up and fan out as they turn for home. Reporting Star still has the lead. Bravo got the split he wants for Flatline, but over the top, Wake Forest with momentum. Patterson Cross and Danish Dynaformer from last. Reporting Star trying to dig in. Wake Forest trying to surge past. Wake Forest on the outside is hoying it on to win it. Wake Forest got the money. Patterson Cross, it came from the clouds to get second in 2:13-2.
Nine horses within about a length and a half, ladies and gentlemen. Four horse photo finish for the superfecta. Wake Forest, the 2-1 favorite, Chad Brown, Javier Castellano, They score the victory, returning $6 even. Patterson Cross finishes second, and the second longest shot at 29-1 with Julian Leperu in the saddle, reporting star, finishes third. And now for the Piez de Resistance, three-year-olds in the Fountain of Youth.
And they're off in the Express Bet Fountain of Youth Stakes. It was a great beginning for Three Rules, who's heading off for the early lead. Irish War Cry moves with him in the early stages. Tackleful is four wide. Three wide is Made You Look. From behind the speed race, Quinientos, and looking for eight. Practical Joke had to tap on the brakes pretty badly there. A stretch of another two lengths back to Hard Logistics. Then at the inside, second last, is Hurricane Americo. And Gunavera drops back to trail the field, tenth and last, as they round the first turn. Up front, the leader is Three Rules. And Joel Rosario keeps the Holy Bull winner in the clear here with Irish War Cry in second. Racing from third, it's Made You Look. Tackleful is now ducked to the inside for Paco Lopez. A Bit Keen fourth. Stretch of another five to Looking for Eight. Then comes Practical Joke. Down at the inside, Quinientos. Gunavera moves up two spots. Second last, Talk Logistics. And Hurricane Americo, the Peruvian, is last of all through an opening half mile in 47 seconds flat. Three Rules bumps the margin to a length and a quarter. Irish War Cry is in no hurry yet. He's racing second. Tackleful at the inside third. Made You Look has fallen off the mark fourth. Here's Practical Joke moving sharply. Practical Joke given the green light. He's into fourth. He's four lengths off the lead, and he's closing ground, and he's doing it right now. Practical Joke after the leader, Three Rules. Irish War Cry all in, not responding. The jackpot winner, Gunavera's in full stride for Javier Castellano as they race to the top of the stretch in the Fountain of Youth, and there goes Practical Joke to confront Three Rules on the top end. But Gunavera looms large off the speed as they turn for home with a short stretch to work with. With the lead, it's Practical Joke, but Gunavera over the top is on to the front now. Three Rules battles on gamely. These three well clear of the others, but it will be Gunavera and Javier Castellano moving clear. Gunavera for local trainer Antonio Sano romps in the Fountain of Youth. Practical Joke second. Three Rules third. Fourth, Talk Logistics in 1:44-1.
A brilliant performance by the winner from last to first at Gulfstream Park, going a mile and a 16th. Does it easily, wins by 5 3/4. Third choice in the wagering, Gunavera. The offspringer dialed in, returns $10.40. Practical Joke, I thought, was a very good second here for Chad Brown. Three Rules finishes second. Irish War Cry, recent winner of the Holy Bull, the even money favorite, looked beat at the half mile pole, finishes seventh. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, two stops in the Pelican State, Delta Downs, and the Fairgrounds.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTV's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTV mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play. In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Hey, we've got a new show.
We do.
Absolutely, And They're Off, right here on the OTB TV network Sunday mornings.
What's it all about?
It'll be a lot of fun. Fast-paced, plenty of topics, guests, handicapping, commentary, and maybe some opinions.
I have opinions on my opinions.
And we will have plenty of them because you're on the show. And They're Off, Sunday mornings here on the OTB TV network, 10 a.m. each Sunday. Should be a lot of fun. Anthony Mormino, Seth Merrow, we'll see you there.
I'm sorry, I went.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning attention to Friday evening at Delta Downs, the Take Charge Brandy.
And they're off. And the Take Charge Brandy at Delta Downs. She's Tricky broke inward down at the rail, but quickly recovered. Coming away fast, Perfect Prediction charging right out to the lead. Behind that one is Joyful Noise trying to move up in the middle here is Long-Legged Model. And between those, it's Javiera. Down on the inside, that She's Tricky as Golden Mischief has dropped back about six lengths off the lead and now is well off the rail going into the first turn. The back two at this point are Brookie and the trailer chases Dixie Belle. They went a quarter mile in 23.70. They race to the backstretch. Perfect Prediction leads by a length and a quarter. On the outside, Joyful Noise is in pursuit, racing in second. She's Tricky is now third as they go past the half-mile pole. On the outside, it's Javier, about four and a half lengths off the lead, followed by Golden Mischief, starting to move up just a bit in the middle of the track. Then comes Long-Legged Model, and still at the back here, you'll find Brookie, and that trailer chases Dixie Belle. On to the far turn, Perfect Prediction trying to steal it all on the front end. The half went in 48.20. She leads by two and a half. Moving up on the inside, She's Tricky to the outside. Golden Mischief is trying to rally. She's in fourth and still has a lot of work to do. From there, Javier is dropping out. They're coming to the top of the lane. It's Perfect Prediction by nearly three. She's Tricky is all out. Golden Mischief trying to catch up here as they straighten away in the lane. Perfect Prediction has the lead. Golden Mischief is rolling, but it may be too late. It's Perfect Prediction, and Roberto Morales going to score in the Take Charge Brandy. Golden Mischief was second. She's Tricky checked in third, and fourth was Joyful Noise.
Roberto Morales goes to the front, makes every pole a winning one. Perfect Prediction. Oh, we certainly hope so. Scores the victory, Larry Jones, the former governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. Brereton Jones owns the Familiar Silks, wins by 3 1/4, returns $10.80 for the offspring of Majestic Perfection. The 1-2 favorite, Golden Mischief, can do no better than second. She's Tricky finishes third. Now headed over to New Orleans Way, the fairgrounds. On Tuesday, they ran the Mardi Gras.
They're off, racing in the Mardi Gras Stakes to a very level start. And there goes Clarination, who strikes out for the lead, along with Boom Bam Bing, also vying for the pace. It's Boom Bam Bing who just leads. Clarination has the white cap. Lovable is third near the speed, along with Wheatfield. They're well grouped going past the half-mile pole. On the far outside, Simple Surprise. Up the inside, Blip in the by. Equation is next, some four lengths off these well-grouped leaders as they enter the turn. And Rapid Rhythm, worked off the inside part of the course by James Graham, has dropped back to last. The quarter went past in 22 3/5 seconds. Leader Clarination. Lovable List spots up on the outside. Right there is Wheatfield. Boom Bam Bing is under pressure. Blip in the by, two by quarter pole. Far outside is Simple Surprise, Equation, and Rapid Rhythm. Over here on the stand side, using every blade of fairgrounds grass. Half mile, 46 1/5 seconds. There's a furlong to go. Simple Surprise bearing down. Wheatfield is right there, just leads. And here comes Rapid Rhythm with his resolute rally. It's Rapid Rhythm and Wheatfield. Rapid Rhythm in the Mardi Gras Stakes. Took it from Wheatfield. Third close, Simple Surprise with Blip in the by. Equation finished near a stand side. Then Boom Bam Bing. Lovable List dropped away, as did Clarination.
And on Fat Tuesday, it was Rapid Rhythm. The 6-5 favorite wins the photo finish from last to first. James Graham aboard, turns $4.60. Wheatfield finishes second. Simple Surprise finishes third. Saturday afternoon at the fairgrounds on the turf in the Dixie Poker Ace.
And they're off in the Dixie Poker Ace Stakes. Let us be glad. Hail to the Nile, Trust Factor. Between horses, Hopeful Notion has the white cap and now settles in back of Hail to the Nile and Trust Factor, who's come forward. And Benwell has dropped back to last at the turn, being led by Hail to the Nile, who just leads Trust Factor, who's second and close up there for Colby Hernandez. As they go to the back of the course, it's Hail to the Nile, the leader. For Cisco Torres, 23 4/5, it's Hail to the Nile from Trust Factor, a break of four more. For the inside is Let Us Be Glad in third position, clear of Hopeful Notion. And Benwell is last of the five, still Hail to the Nile and Trust Factor. Heading to the half-mile pole, Hail to the Nile continues to cut out the pace here with Trust Factor. The stakes favorite, second on the outside with four furlongs to go. Hail to the Nile and Trust Factor, half-mile 47 4/5 seconds. Let Us Be Glad third, looking to creep into this toward the rail there for Gabriel Saez. We come back to Benwell underneath of Hopeful Notion, racing a joint last, three furlongs to go. Trust Factor now puts this move on Hail to the Nile. Trust Factor has forged to a very short lead from at the inside Hail to the Nile. Now here's Let Us Be Glad's challenge as they turn for the quarter pole. Ben Will and Hopeful Notion over here on the stand side. 3/4 in 1:12 3/5 seconds. Let Us Be Glad has taken a short lead. Trust Factor will need to re-rally in the final furlong. Ben Will on the outside, Hopeful Notion. Hail to the Nile is dropped back. They come past the 16th with Gabriel Saez. Let Us Be Glad leads home the charge. Let Us Be Glad takes out the Dixie Poker Ace Stakes from Trust Factor. Ben Will third, Hopeful Notion, Hail to the Nile, trailed home the stakes quintet.
Let Us Be Glad. Gabriel Saez wins impressively by 2.5 lengths, returning $15.80. Trust Factor, the 6-5 favorite, finishes second. Ben Will finishes third. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Turfway Park and Oaklawn.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's Sales and Marketing Department today. You're unbelievable.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love racing? RTN brings you every live simulcast on your home television, plus live video streaming and race replays on your PC and mobile devices. To order, visit RTN.tv. RTN, a breed apart.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Saturday evening at Turfway Park, annually the big prep race for the, well, the Spiral, the Jim Beam, the Latonia, the Galaxy Furniture. Whatever name that big 9-furlong race is, the mile and a 16th John Pataglia Memorial.
And they're off in the Pataglia. Enhanced brakes sharply from the outside, but on the inside, that's Mon 2 with Star Empire. Up between horses, Hunk of Burning Love into the first turn. From the rail, Mon 2 moves through, puts ahead in front. Hunk of Burning Love second. Enhance on the outside, third ahead. Star Empire down along the rail, fourth. Gappa, four. Strike Your Light is fifth by ahead. Then Durango Dan, followed on the outside by Fulkerson. It's a gap of 5 more lengths to It's Your Nickel. Then through from the inside, Hot Dad. The trail, or then it's Sail and Shoes in a big gap. Back to the trailer, Gorgeous Kit in the half. 47-3. Montu still has a head in front. Hunk of Burning Love is second. Gaining up on the outside, and Hance moves up closer third. From the inside, Star Empire runs fourth. Fulkerson up on the outside, fifth ahead. Durango Dan sixth. From the inside in seventh, that's It's Your Nickel. Hot Dad is gaining ground. They got 3/4 in 11-4, and Enhance has moved by. Enhance has the lead. Here comes It's Your Nickel. In the center of the track, It's Your Nickel just blows by Enhance, who's still second. Then Montu from the inside, Star Empire. Late run from Hot Dad, Durango Dan. But It's Your Nickel and James Graham just draw off to dominate in the Pataglia, win by 6 or 7. Enhance held second. Photo for third. Running time for the Pataglia, 1:44-3.
It's Your Nickel, 2-1 favorite. Never gives his bank backers an anxious moment. Ken McPeak, James Graham, they win by 6.5, returning 680. Enhance finishes second. Star Empire finishes third. Over to Oaklawn Park, up first, the gazebo.
They're off. Aristocratic breaks well, so does Laughing Saint Song. These two are fast. Rockshaw splits those two, and Rockshaw's up into third. Then comes Ballandine and 747, who was astride slow. Prado's Way, and the early trailer is Doc Kane as they sprint up the backstretch. In the sixth running of the gazebo, and Laughing Saint's Song is the leader. From the outside to the rail, he leads it by a half length over Rockshaw in second. Ballandine and Aristocratic are together third and fourth. They're both two from the front. 747 is fifth now, and he's five lengths off the lead. Then Doc Kane, and the trailer is Prado's Way. They are round the far turn. Laughing Saint Song and Rockshaw, and these two at the quarter mile marker, and they are right together. Rockshaw is outside. Laughing Saint Song at the rail, and Rockshaw has strongly run to the front. He is now a length in front of Laughing Saint Song in second. To the outside, and Aristocratic, and between horses goes Ballandine, but it is Rockshaw clear. Rockshaw 16th out, and now he's pouring it on. He is four in front. Laughing Saint Song and Ballandine. Rockshaw wins. And he wins big in the gazebo, four and a half. Laughing Saint Song was second, Ballandine third, and Doc Kane finished fourth.
Rockshaw, Giovanni Franco in the saddle, the 2-1 favorite for Ron Moquette, the offspring of McLean's Music, wins the 6 furlong stakes by 4 lengths, returns $6.20. Laughing Saint Song finishes second. Ballandine finishes third. Also on Saturday afternoon, the Spring Fever.
They're off. DRC's Pretty Sky and Kath Ballou with Marquee Miss and Fantastic Style. Here's Fantastic Style to Pokerhead in front. Then Super Sax, and the early trailer is Natural Wonder, and they mix it up the backstretch. Kath Ballou's at the rail. Fantastic Style is two deep. Marquee Miss three deep. DRC's Pretty Sky four wide, and Super Sax five wide. Five of the six across the track, leaving the backstretch in the 29th Spring Fever, and the trailer is Natural Wonder and Fantastic Style is the leader. Fantastic Style just ahead in front of Marquee Miss, who's on the attack in second. Kath Ballou is right there at the rail. DRC's Pretty Sky, Super Sax has dropped out. Any one of four as they head to the top of the stretch. Kath Ballou rides the rail. Fantastic Style, Marquee Miss running straight today, and these three come to the final 16th. Marquee Miss outside. Kath Ballou at the rail. Fantastic Style between horses. What a race, and even here comes DRC's Pretty Sky. Kath Ballou for Gorgeous Marquee Miss, Kath Ballou. Kath Ballou won, and Natural Wonder came from absolutely nowhere. I think she might have got second over Marquee Miss in third.
Kath Ballou for Ken McPeak and Channing Hill. They score the victory by 3/4 of a length, returning $12.20. The only horse above 10-1 at nearly 24-1, Natural Wonder, from last to second. Marquee Miss finishes third. The 4-5 favorite, Fantastic Style, finishes fifth. Take our final break. When we come back, Santa Anita and the Big A.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Not at the track and not near a computer? No problem. Wager with Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System and you'll never get shut out again. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System is quick, simple to use, and guarantees your wagers are accurate and placed on time. For more information, visit CapitalOTB.com or call Capital OTB's customer service hotline at 800-292-BETS. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System. Never get shut out again.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends.
conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Saturday afternoon at the Great Race Place. Last year, Jerry Holland offers sent out Songbird One Word at 1 to 20. On Saturday, Unique Bella was 1 to 10.
Racing. Mistress of the Night was off dreadfully. What commences nicely with Tapital Spooky Woods. Unique Bella comes away fourth. She's 2.5 lengths off the early lead. And in turn three, clear of Abel Tasman, and Mistress of the Night is back last of all. Tapital has the lead. Unique Bella desperate to get off the rail. Smith pushing Spooky Woods a little bit wide, and Unique Bella now moving up second. Around the first turn, and Tapital is joined quickly by Unique Bella. Smith wasting no time in sending the favourite to the lead. Unique Bella striding away a length and a half from Tapital. Spooky Woods is three lengths back third. What on the inside fourth. A gap of four lengths to Abel Tasman, and Mistress of the Night six lengths last. Unique Bella is off with a 2.5 length lead in the middle stages. From Tapital, Spooky Woods is third. What fourth. Abel Tasman fifth. 12 off the leader, and five lengths to Mistress of the Night. Smith stringing them out. It's Unique Bella coming into the far turn by four lengths. Her stablemate, Spooky Woods, moves up second, overtaking Tapital. What is next? Abel Tasman into the three path, goes to a level third, but has eight lengths to make up on Unique Bella, coming around past the 5/16th pole in the Santa Isabel. Unique Bella by five. Abel Tasman coming home strongly to second, overtaking Spooky Woods. Then comes What, turning for home, and Smith hasn't asked Unique Bella for anything yet. She leads three lengths. Left-handed whip from Talamo on Abel Tasman, and she's coming after Unique Bella. Unique Bella being tackled by Abel Tasman, and Unique Bella now feels the whip from Smith at the 16th pole, immediately responds. The threat from Abel Tasman is subsiding, and Unique Bella, after having to be livened up briefly at the 8th pole, takes the Santa Isabel 2.5 lengths. Abel Tasman a game second. Spooky Woods 7 off third, then Mistress of the Night.
And just a quick comment in the Daily Racing Form. It reads in the beginning, Unique Bella pulled and came off the rail to be in tight between foes. I'm rather sure that Unique Bella bowled her way in on the first turn through horses for Mike Smith. But the offspring of Tappet wins by 2.25. She was threatened at the 8th pole, but you saw her set down under Mike Smith and return $2.20. Abel Tasman finishes second. Spooky Woods, who met Unique Bella up close and personal on the first turn, finishes third. Also on Saturday afternoon, named after the longtime announcer at Santa Anita, down the hill in the Joe Hernandez.
Racing. Perfectly Majestic, slow to move, and Forest Chatter was poorly away. Dancing Candy, mustering speed along the inside, has gone to the lead from Forever Juanito and No Silent Stormy Liberal. Forest Chatter picking up ground quickly to fifth on the inside of Fabozzi, and then Clever Royal outside Perfectly Majestic. No Silent, Dancing Candy, Forever Juanito are jousting for the lead. A length in front of Stormy Liberal, Forest Chatter, Fabozzi. It's a bunched field, Perfectly Majestic and Clever Royal, the last two, only five lengths front to back. It's Dancing Candy making his turf debut off an eight-month layoff, getting away with the lead over No Silent. About three-quarters of a length now for Dancing Candy at the 3/8. Stormy Liberal's out wide. He's moving into contention stylishly, going easily past Forever Juanito. Forest Chatter back along the inside. Fabozzi next, and Perfectly Majestic and Clever Royal hook out very deep. Stormy Liberal has gone straight by Dancing Candy in upper stretch. Then Perfectly Majestic, Fabozzi, Clever Royal, Forest Chatter, but Stormy Liberal kicks well clear at the 8th pole from Dancing Candy. Perfectly Majestic is rallying gamely. Stormy Liberal under threat late from Perfectly Majestic. Stormy Liberal, Perfectly Majestic. Photo in the Hernandez. Stormy Liberal just beat Perfectly Majestic. Dancing Candy third, narrowly ahead of Fabozzi.
Stormy Liberal, Peter Miller, who's been on a roll for about the last 4 or 5 months, sends out the winner, Roberto Arroyo, aboard, winning the photo finish on the 6-5 favorite. The offspring of Stormy Atlantic returns $4.60. Perfectly Majestic finishes second. Dancing Candy finishes third. Sunday afternoon, Distaffer is sprinting in the Las Flores.
Racing. sensitively from the middle gate, pings out, goes straight to the lead from Pretty and Cool and Constellation, and then the Bolters pair watch this Cat and Pondalee sensitively just in front of Pretty and Cool, and they're followed by Constellation. Watch this Cat and Pondalee up along the inside, 2.5 lengths covering the quintet. Sensitively is the leader, narrowly from Pretty and Cool with a half mile to go. Constellation sitting a length off them in the three path. Pondalee back along the inside, and watch this Cat splits fillies fifth and last. It remains a compact unit at the 3/8 pole in the Las Flores. Sensitively joined by Pretty and Cool. Pretty and Cool taking the lead from Sensitively, followed by Constellation in intensifying rain. Pondalee is fourth. Watch this Cat drops out, turning for home, and Pretty and Cool dashes away by 3 lengths to Sensitively. Constellation followed by Pondalee in the vicinity of the 8th pole, and it's Pretty and Cool off a 6-month layoff, going great guns. 4 in front. Pondalee is coming through between fillies almost to join Constellation. Sensitively fading out of the trifecta, but Pretty and Cool makes a dashing return to the track. Second, Constellation. Pondalee was third.
Pretty and Cool. Bob Baffert is reunited with Martin Garcia. They score the victory, returning $11.80. The 4-5 favorite, Constellation, can do no better than second. Pondalee, the long shot on the board at 17-1, finishes third. Headed back east for the big A, two stakes races on Saturday afternoon. Up first, the Heavenly Prize.
And they're off. Isabel, mid-pack, bounces out on top. Genre with some early speed, too, but Isabel is quicker and secures the lead bias the first time. Genre's running in second. Andy rocks very wide to the opening turn as Isabel goes wide to that spot. Still 5 or 6 paths off the rail is Isabel now, angles over to the inside. Meanwhile, Chorus Line slipped up the inside to grab third. So they sort themselves out, and it is Isabel in front by 2. Genre prompts from second, and then it's Chorus Line settling in toward the inside. Third, Annie Rocks, fourth by 2.5. Oasis at Midnight at the back with Family of Roses. So onto the back stretch. Isabel's opening quarter mile was 24 1/5 seconds, just outside of 5 furlongs to go, and she's unopposed so far. Still leading by 2. Genre continues to chase from second. Chorus Line covered up inside while third. Andy Rocks is in the clear racing fourth. Second, third, and fourth horses all getting closer, though, to Isabel, who hits the half-mile pole, still in front by 1. On to the far turn now. Isabel, the opening half was 49 seconds flat. Andy Rocks moves up into second. And then it's Chorus Line back in third. Genre's been shuffled back into fourth. As they round the far turn, Isabel steps on it now. Opens up by 3 lengths, heading for the quarter pole. Chorus Line down inside of Annie Rocks. Genre not today. Farther back, Oasis at Midnight and Family of Roses off the turn. It's all Isabel, who's got a 4, now a 5-length lead heading for midstretch. Chorus Line is all out, but is well back in second. Annie Rocks and Genre, there's a furlong to go, and Isabel has blown this open. Now clear by 10, maybe 12, opening up with every stride, coast to coast for Isabel in the Heavenly Prize. Genre is going to get up to be second. Chorus Line was third, and Oasis at Midnight was fourth.
Highway Star scratched out, and Isabel, the 7-5 second choice, goes to the front, improves the position for the New York bred, wins by 12, returning $4.80. Genre, the even money favorite, can do no better than second. Chorus Line finishes third. And a true sign of almost spring in New York, 3-year-olds in the Gotham.
And they're off. Decent start for Ella Reeb, and so too J-Boy's Echo from the inside. True Timber showing some speed too, and Cloud Computing on the far outside is up close as well as they race for the clubhouse turn. Ella Reeb running well off the rails, joined on the outside by True Timber, and they head into the opening turn together. Cloud Computing settles in behind, racing along in third. J-Boy's Echo comes away in fourth. Action Every Day wide on the track while fifth. So Conflated, second to last early. Gaetano's the last of them all. So it is Ella Reeb who now takes a clear lead onto the backstretch run. True Timber, though, keeps the pressure up, pushed along to keep up with Ella Reeb through the opening half mile. Good trip so far for Cloud Computing, just in behind racing third. The opening quarter, very solid, 23-2. Six more lengths back to J-Boy's Echo, racing fourth and eight lengths off the lead. Five more from there to Action Every Day, followed by So Conflated. And at the back is Gaetano in a very strung out field. Ella Reeb with a half mile to go, still maintaining a narrow lead to True Timber second. Cloud Computing set to strike in behind while third. Meanwhile, J-Boy's Echo is winding up from fourth, getting closer with every stride as that one, as they round the far turn. Ella Reeb is still the leader. True Timber is still second. Cloud Computing rallies up on the outside from third and now second. J-Boy's Echo's coming with a four-wide blitz on the far outside. At the top of the stretch, Ella Reeb with plenty of company turning for home. And just like that off the turn, J-Boy's Echo has taken charge. Cloud Computing fights on. Ella Reeb checked toward the inside and is giving it up late. Racing for the eighth pole, J-Boy's Echo has gone clear now by two, now by three. Cloud Computing angles outside for a final try, but J-Boy's Echo is gone in the Gotham. J-Boy's Echo from off the pace wins it by three. Solid effort from Cloud Computing to be second by another five. Ella Reeb managed third. Action Every Day was fourth.
J-Boy's Echo, who hit the board most recently in New York, second choice in the wagering, gets everything his way this time and scores the impressive 3.5-length victory for Dale Romans and Robbie Alvarado, returning $14.80 for the good guys. Cloud Computing, talked about Practical Joke earlier for Chad Brown. I thought this was another very good second-place finish in only the second career start. Runs very well. Ella Reeb, the 2-5 favorite, finishes third. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off-Track Betting.